Hi, this is Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanwatko-Trillo. It's always touching to read an inspiring line or two, especially these days when people are resigned to the negative things all around them. It's even more uplifting when fun, cheerful illustrations go with these words of wisdom, moving quotes, and Bible verses. Today, we'll get an inspirational boost from the works and designs of two artists. First up, we have with us Robert Alejandro. He's the Raw in Papemel Roti, everyone's favorite gift shop. Robert and his sisters are the creative minds behind the designs of Papemel Roti's products. Hello, Robert, and thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah. The name of the store is almost like a tongue twister. A lot of people think it's Papemel Roti, but it's Papemel Roti, right?
Yeah, but they can pronounce it any which way they want.
Okay, I remember the store since when I was a kid. When exactly did it start and how?
I think it started in the 70s pa. It started, my mom and had a store of her own. It was called Corben, which is from my mom's name, Corit and Benny. And then Papemel Roti started as a joke that we should have a store, which was Papemel Roti.
Which is you and your five siblings.
Exactly.
Right? Okay. And what made you decide to go into gift products with, you know, like an inspirational side to it? Was the inspirational side something there from the beginning, or it sort of crept its way in there a few years down the line?
It was there right from the beginning, and it's because that's the kind of people we are. It could sound very, PR or too nice, but the truth is that's who we are, that's how we were brought up, and so it was there.
Right, okay. So you guys make everything from notebooks to posters to gift boxes to whatnot. Who designs these?
We do. So as you said, we're five children in the family and we all design, we're all artists and we all love to create stuff, and so that's what we do.
Okay, and are your inspirations all from the Bible, or you get them from maybe philosophers or something?
It's funny because in our family, we have our own little project, even my mom and my dad, and so so there are a bunch of products that are inspirational from the Bible, but then we also do products about the Philippines, like I do drawings about the Philippines, and then there's stuff about the family, and so they're all different as well.
Right, everybody has their own special source of inspiration.
Exactly.
I guess, right? So all of you are artists, all of you design. Mm-hmm. Are there fixed hours during which you do this at the office, or are you designing all day?
Since we're owners, we practically do it 24 hours, so it's not actually like an office job. And frankly, it's also our passion. Like, I love to do things with my hand, so you can't stop that. So you practically do it all day.
So you're doing it all day.
Yeah.
Okay, having said that, who takes care of the business side of things?
Well, we have people, and then my sisters as well do the, you know, the management and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I don't do, because I have my own business as well. So
okay, aside from
this,
okay.
So yeah, mostly my sister does the stuff that nobody wants to do.
So I'm assuming that the thing that everybody enjoys most is the designing and the drawing.
Of course.
That's the most fun part of,
exactly,
of the business.
Nobody wants to talk to the government.
Right? Nobody wants to deal with the tax thing.
Exactly.
This month, right? How do you make your products, how do you develop your products and, you know, make them more and more relevant for a fast changing world?
It's funny because we don't really have this plan, you know, business plan. It's more like, what is really your passion? What do you want to do? And that's what we create. We make samples, and then of course we show it to one another, and then it goes right into production. Since we own the business, so it's no problem, you know, we don't have a client.
Right.
And so it's more like it's really run by our passion.
There's so much freedom there for you guys as artists, right? But is there a certain kind of style that that you need to adhere to for the store, for the brand? No,
not even. Since we're the owners and everyone has their own style. But the funny thing is, there is a Pape Melruti look, I hear.
Yeah, exactly. I was going to say that. That's why I asked that question.
But no, there's no like, no, that's too modern or what. No, everybody does whatever they want to do.
Yeah. As a family business, how do you guys deal with, you know, conflicts and disagreements?
Oh, that can be really messy and bad, as you know, with family businesses. But then there's no other way to resolve it but talk. Sometimes there's crying, but yeah.
Okay, whatever gets you through
exactly.
It, right? Right. What are the types of things that we can expect from the store this year and in the future?
As I was saying, we constantly design, and so a lot of times when the customers come to the store, there's always something new. My sisters have been brewing a lot of new jewelry with our new design, and some are inspirational, and so they're really into that, so they're going to see a lot of that soon, even more.
Right, that sounds like a lot of fun. We have your website there on the screen. Mm-hmm. Does that mean people can buy online, or you just show the products from
there? No, you can buy online, and that's been happening from all over the world as well. So we have a clientele from all over the world.
Yeah, because the Pape Melruti always kind of struck me as the kind of store that the Balikbayans also really like, right?
Yeah, you bet.
Yeah, because I think there's a very Filipino flavor to it. What kind of feedback do you get from the Balikbayans and the foreigners?
Oh, it's there are certain stores, actually, because we have around 15 stores around Manila, mm-hmm. and there are certain stores I know around Manila where there are more Balikbayans and foreigners that... that's the kind of items they're looking for, more Filipiniana stuff. Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, okay, before we let you go, of course, you have to tell us where your stores are and where Pape Melruti is available.
Most of the major stores are in most of Metro Manila's stores. There are 15 branches, so there's a whole lot. The best thing for them to do is really to go to the website to take a look at the rundown of the stores.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, there you have some images of the store right there. Your stores have gotten really big.
Yeah, my favorite store, because we've been renovating, because it's more than 40 years now. So my favorite store is in SM Mega Mall, so it's a lot brighter, so it's a lot more modern. Well, not modern, but really, I like it the best, because it's a lot more brighter. Yeah,
it looks really big. Are there certain products that you would say are your favorite inspirational works within the store?
Of course, my work.
Your own,
But then if you ask my sister, it's their work as well.
It's whatever your your babies are in there, right? What else inspires you, would you say, aside from the Bible, in terms of the look and the actual artwork?
You know what, it's funny, because as you go through life, you get inspired by so much stuff. Like, I read a book and it really means so much to me. And so the next thing I'm doing, I'm creating products from what I've read. It can be like that. Or you're just riding a jeepney and you see something. So inspiration comes from anywhere and everywhere.
Do you ever suffer a creative block, though?
Well, sometimes, then I just go to sleep. But hardly, really. I'm very blessed that I'm passionate about what we're doing, so no creative blocks, really.
Right. We were talking about the stores earlier. Do you have a say in the way the store looks and the way things are laid out? Or when your sisters aren't looking, do you put your products in the front or something like that?
Yes, everyone has a say, mm-hmm. But... No, we don't really want the I mean, you know, I don't really push my products or what. Maybe my father does, but but we all have a say, and it's no problem naman. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised that a family that's in this kind of enterprise works very harmoniously.
Yeah, to a certain extent, yeah.
Okay, Robert, thank you so much for coming on Shop Talk.
Thank you.
All right. Well, we have more inspiring products for you, this time from Sheena Loves Sunsets. That's coming up right after this break. Stay tuned. Shop Talk will be right back.